Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Congressman. I'm a college student just months away from getting my undergraduate degree.
Congratulations.
I, like almost everyone here, am deeply concerned about the dysfunctional mess this and it. Mess in inexcusable.
Take time.
Deeply concerned about the mess and dysfunction this government, especially this administration, is leaving my generation, my children's generation, and probably their kids' generation as well. Both times this president took his oath of office, he swore, and I quote, to preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States. Clearly, he has not done so. He has broken his oath of office. President Obama has committed dozens of impeachable offenses, ranging from illegally having an American population under surveillance and even circumventing congressional authority. And you, Congressman Burgess, you have also sworn, and I quote, to support and defend the Constitution of the United States from all enemies, foreign and domestic, and to faithfully discharge the duties of the office. In my hand, I have a list of the offenses President Obama has committed for you or anyone else to see.
Will you leave that with me?
Yes, I will.
Thank you.
And you have also publicly stated your opinion on impeachment, stating, and I quote, things need to be tied up. The longer we allow things to continue, the damage to continue in check, the worse things are going to be for us. I agree. Now, there are two ways in which to file for impeachment. One is by offering a resolution to the House. The other is by submitting a bill of impeachment to the House Judiciary Committee. My question to you, Congressman, is why aren't you doing your job, and why haven't you impeached the President yet?
Well, for you, I don't know if you're old enough to remember the impeachment of William Jefferson Clinton. And the House of Representatives did, through the Judiciary Committee, produce the Articles of Impeachment, and it passed the House of Representatives. Never went anywhere in the Senate. The Senate environment today is less friendly toward that notion than it was in 1998. Yeah, I would tie things up, but tie everything up, and tie up the House of Representatives. And I would just ask you, to what end? The Articles of Impeachment will be filed. I don't know whether they will pass or not, but even if they did, is conviction going to happen in the Senate? Without conviction, removal from office going to occur? So to what end are you asking for that to happen?
I'm asking what it's going to take for you to file for impeachment.
Well, I'll be happy to look at your list. To date, I have not seen the issue that would require that. I was hopeful that you and I and enough of our fellow citizens would recognize the dire problem that existed and fix it 6 months ago. And that did not happen. And as a consequence, I have to live with the will of the people who under the Constitution voted for their commander-in-chief.
Okay, you're saying that you haven't seen evidence to support your reasons for impeachment.
I'll be happy to look at your list. So it becomes a legislative equivalent of stamping your feet and holding your breath.
Okay. How many constituents is it going to take to call your office, write you letters, and demand that you file for impeachment?
I don't know the answer to that.
May we ask?
See, I'm not allowed to be political, so I thank you for your observation. That's very kind of you. I'll be happy to receive your list, and I'll if you leave contact information, you can get back.
I definitely will. But all it takes is one represent one elected official to file for impeachment, to get it to the Judiciary Committee, to vote.
Yeah, and you saw what happened when Dennis Kucinich did that against George W. Bush, you know, two or three Congresses ago. You saw what happened when, I think it was even John Conyers, who was the ranking member on the Judiciary Committee. And that was when Bush was president. I didn't think that was a very good idea. But even as hostile as the Democratic House of Representatives came to be towards George Bush after they took the majority, that's not something that they did. But look, if you don't have, and if you're going to end up in a place where all you've done is achieved passage of the Articles of Impeachment either in the committee or on the House floor, but nothing changes, you spend an enormous amount of time. Right now, I think our efforts are better spent defunding the Affordable Care Act, as people pointed out here tonight, doing some sensible things with the budget, protecting our military spending, but at the same time, ratcheting down overall spending. I mean, those are the things that can be done. The deficit was $1.3 trillion 2 years ago. $606 billion a day, hardly a cause for celebration, but certainly a move in the right direction. If we allow ourselves to become distracted, we may lose the ground we've already achieved. And I'm happy to receive the list to look at it.
Good evening.
Yes, sir.
Thanks for being here.
Yes, sir.